The stage is empty. The audience seated. Not strictly true, because they're ecstatically on their feet. And I'll tell you, if he wins this, I don't know how we're going to keep the roof in this place. And there he is. And there they are. And here we are seated. And we can't wait. Pictures to be treasured and savored forever and ever and ever. But the man who stands between Amir Khan and his dream is the man who has bestrode this 60-kilogram division like a colossus. Hasn't lost a major championship ever. World champion in 1999, Olympic champion the following year. Won the world title again in 2001 and won it last year, despite having a fractured arm in his quarterfinal. This is how good this man is. There is never a single flicker of emotion on the face of this great warrior, now 33 years of age. He could be old enough to be this fella's dad. Terry Edwards, last couple of sensible, clever words of encouragement from the man who guided Audley Harrison to Olympic gold 4 years ago. We have seen two successive Cuban golds here on this day two of the Olympic boxing finals. Can the baby of British boxing end a Cuban winning sequence? This man aiming to be the sixth Cuban to retain an Olympic title. And it's going to be very difficult for Amir Khan. There's very little that this fella hasn't done and seen and is capable of. But in many ways, we could say the same in terms of capability and potential of this precocious talent. Final private moment. Kindan looks so relaxed, ominously so. He tends to start slowly, just eases himself off that 33-year-old back, comes off the ropes, and here we go, Khan straight into action. Kindan sensed that, sniffed it out, moved away from it. This is going to be a great tactical battle. We've said about styles making contests. Look at Khan, first point to the teenager.
Yes, coming out well here, very positive. Looking for that right hand. It was a good shot to throw against the southpaw. What he's got to do though, Jim, he's got to get in there and then he's got to go. He can't afford to hold his feet against Kindan.
2-1 to Khan. Stepping in with it, making the great champion work. Kindan has eased and just cajoled and teased his way through the round so far. Culminated with a semi-final against a good Russian Krachev. Amir Khan had it perhaps a little bit harder, had a tough man from Kazakhstan. But in the end, he was the better boxer. Little teasing punch, trying to draw down the guard of Khan, and he's picked up another one. 3-2 now, into the second half of the first round. Good little exchange. Khan's picked him off again, and again. Well, maturity is oozing out of every pore of Khan. He's got him again. That didn't land. Wonderful appreciation there by Kindan of space and time. Khan is bouncing and Kindan has taken the centre of the ring. Not sure that Kindan did a land there. Good footwork once again. Khan get picked off, but he's still leading. He's behind at the end of the first in a semi and at the end of the second, and then he came storming through. He may well have to do something similar here, and if he does, well, the party will begin in earnest.
He's starting well here, Khan, and he's staying close to his opponent, which is good, because a lot of orthodox fighters fall short against the southpaw, and Khan's not doing that. That's excellent.
Thought he landed with a good right hand there. What a good opening round. Can you believe it? He's taken a round away from the treble world and defending Olympic champion. Kindan not bothered whatsoever. Neither, it seems, is Amir Khan. This is an extraordinarily mature performance. Great start by him. Clever little shot into the middle, but he got caught with the left hand. This could still go either way.
Yeah, very, very close. Khan, excellent stepping in with the shots.
Edwards was telling Amir Khan that when this man comes in with the right hand, get yourself into the middle. Kindan looking very composed as always. Terrific opening round for Amir Khan, 4-3. But I just get the feeling that they're both going at about half pace. might just suit Kindon to keep this contest a bit on the slow side.
Well, Khan just got to keep doing what he's doing, stepping in and actually beating his opponent to the punch. That's excellent from Khan, that's better.
Didn't score. Remember, you've got to land with sufficient force in the target area. It can't just be a tap. Oh, wonderful right hand from Kindle, and that squared it. Khan's got to be careful. Round the corner, shortened the punch beautifully. Now he's stepping up the work rate, and he's moving pretty quickly. Settles himself down, the wily old warhorse. Great right hand by Khan. Good exchange. Kindlin quicker to the punch. Cuban goes ahead for the first time. Khan must be careful about keeping his guard up when he throws the shots. He's got to get the gloves up to the side of the head. Little glimpse of just why Kindlin has been supreme in this division. Wonderful stuff by Khan. Took one, gave one. Cuban still ahead. Again, the counter-punching of Kindlin. A little bit too much. Good right hand by Kindlin. 2 points, he's up. You've got to stay in touch by the halfway stage, Amir.
He's an expert counter-puncher, Kindlin. Just makes you fall short every time, but Khan just going to try and keep him on the end of that long, straight right hand. That's his best shot here.
Kindlin always seems to be able to do enough. Great hand speed. Clipped him round the air, winning. The angle and the distance just seemed beyond even his reach. Good defensive work by Kindlin. This has been a terrific run by the Cuban. There he is again. 5 points. All that experience and all that massive talent coming through. And Kindlin has opened up now a 5-point gap towards the end of the second. This has been the best round of boxing we've seen from Kindlin so far. Well, that's very nice. They met before, remember, in the pre-Olympic tournament. Kindlin won it then by...